People send me emails sometimes when I talk about brainwashing, or when they see me make a video about brainwashing, they're like, yeah, well, you're brainwashing me by me watching it. I'm like, yeah, no shit, I am. Today, we're going to talk about how you can either brainwash yourself or you can be brainwashed. And there's really whatever you want. That's what I'm going to start off by saying. Either you can just go through your life and let your brainwashing happen, or you can actually step up and brainwash yourself. And you may have heard me talk about this in a different way before, but everything that comes into your reality, everything that you can see, hear, taste, smell, touch, all of those things, all are brainwashing you in some sort of way. The music that you listen to, the books that you read, the people that you follow, the Instagram accounts whose stuff that you see, the TV that you watch, every single thing is going to brainwash you in some sort of way. You can either let it or you can be in charge of it. That's what the most important thing is to realize. And we're going to go very, very deep today. Before we do, first off, I want to say this. I have no dog in the fight. I'll be honest. When I say this, I'm not on the left side, I'm not on the right side. I do not follow or worship any political party or political person or politician, none of those things. I'm just telling you what I see from an outsider looking at what's happening in the world and what's happening with people that are stepping into their own power and claiming their own power, or people who are just end up believing the stuff that they see. So I'm just an outsider looking in. What I believe in more than anything else is just letting people have their own experience. I think the reason why we're here on this earth is to have an experience. That's it. Whatever the experiences are all there to teach us and to learn and grow and to get better from. That's what we're here to do. If I try to tell somebody what to do or tell somebody what to believe in or how they should think or any of that stuff, I am impeding on their human experience. So therefore, I just let everybody have their experience. And the one thing that's crazy to me, you know, I'm really going to go deep into your brain and you know, brainwashing yourself or being brainwashed. The one thing that's crazy to me is that if I were to ask you, what do you think people want more than anything else? You know, you might say love, you might say happiness, all that stuff. All of those I would rank high. But one of the things that I think that people overlook a lot is their own freedom to choose what they want to do with who they want. As long as they're not hurting anybody else, I say that's fine. And so the reason why this is, and why I can say this is so deeply ingrained in people, is because if you look at a child that's being told to do something that it doesn't want to do, you can tell that child doesn't want to do it and they put up a fight. So that's how you can tell that even children want their freedom, right? So when you start diving into, you start thinking about this, obviously we can, hopefully you know this, but we can all tell if you look at the news and all of that stuff that there are people or societies or whatever it is that are trying to control people's thoughts in some sort of way, right? There's TV shows, there's podcasts, there's social media channels, all built to control what people think. There's news stations, obviously, I think we all know that at this point, that are trying to control what other people are thinking. And this isn't me being trying to be doom and gloom in any sort of way, it's just a fact. And the more that I distance myself from the people who I follow on social media and start to get rid of that, which I'll talk about in just a minute, and start to not look at any news or any of that stuff, the more I start to distance myself from it, the more that I can see what's actually happening. It's like when you get outside of the jar, you can't read the label. Or when you get outside of the jar, you can finally read the label. I feel like I'm much more out of the jar, and I'm sure there's even deeper down the rabbit hole we could go. You have to get yourself out of the jar and say, like, what is it that is constantly coming into my awareness that I'm hearing and seeing and all of that stuff that I'm surrounding myself with? The funny thing about it is that when you distance yourself from all that and you just allow yourself to experience the world and walk outside, life is amazing. Like, it's pretty amazing if you really think about it, right? Like, if you look at the news, you're like, oh my God, we're all gonna die. We're all going to hell in a handbasket. Earth is, we're all screwed. Like, that's what the news looks like, right? But then you walk outside and you're like, yeah, it's pretty normal out here. It's the same way it was when I was younger. And it's pretty amazing and it's pretty beautiful and life's pretty amazing, right? But that's only if you surround yourself with things that make you feel amazing. Right? So I want you to realize this. It's amazing only when you control what's coming into your brain. So here's the reason why I'm talking about this and starting to dive into the meat and taters here. Your brain has a limited amount of stuff you can put in. It has a limited amount of knowledge that you can put into it and energy every single day. you eventually run out of energy every single day. Your brain eventually goes, all right, I'm done for the day, dude. Like, I'm tired. Let's chill. Right? So I want you to imagine your brain like a box. You know, if you've ever moved from one place to another, you go into your kitchen, you pull out, you go, you know what? This can be my kitchen box. I'm going to put dishes in here. I'm going to put the forks and the knives in here. I'm going to put the cups and the mugs. I'm going to put the towels in here, you know, the kitchen towels. I'm going to put all of the kitchen stuff in here. You can't fill that box up forever. Eventually, that box is going to become full. The same way that your brain is eventually going to become full as well. That's how your brain is. So the people that you talk to, the environment that you surround yourself with, the stuff that you see on TV, the podcasts that you listen to, the social media that you scroll through, all of those things are like putting more into your box, putting more into your box. You can look at the box and go, I want all of this stuff. Or you can look at the box and say, I don't want half this, right? Like it's like, maybe I should take this to Goodwill because I don't want this stuff. The news, I don't want, I can take that to Goodwill. I don't want the news, right? Now that person that I follow on social media, I don't want that. I need to get rid of, they can go to Goodwill. I'm gonna drop them off at Goodwill as well. Don't need that. Salvation Army, go ahead and take it. So you start looking at it and you look at your brain as if it were a box that you're packing every single day, as if you were just gonna go move somewhere else. And ask yourself, is the stuff that I'm packing into my box, AKA my brain, the things that I want to take with me into tomorrow? I'm moving from today into tomorrow. I'm moving this box from today into tomorrow. Is this the stuff that I want to move? Or maybe I should start to donate some stuff to Salvation Army, Goodwill, and get rid of it. Because eventually the box is gonna fill up. But the question is, did you fill up the box with what it is that you want? Or did your box just happen to fill up throughout the day because you were being unintentional? So the way that I think of it is every bit of information that comes into your brain, every single thing that you do at every single second is filling the box in some sort of way. I had something happen to me a couple weeks ago. I got onto social media and I saw a video that somebody posted. This is probably like 8 a.m. I'd been up for an hour and a half, 2 hours, whatever it was. I was fine. You know, normally I'm super tired in the morning and just kind of chill, all that stuff. And I felt good. Nothing was wrong. And then a couple hours later, I was like, man, I feel like I've been anxious today. Like, I feel like I've been like kind of out of it. Like, I don't feel really great today. You know, the sun's shining. I don't know why I feel like And then I was like, why do I feel like this? Did I eat something? No, I didn't really eat something that was bad. You know, I've had my coffee, but I didn't have too much of it, so I shouldn't be anxious. And then I went, oh, this morning, I literally saw a video about all of how bad the world is and how we're going to hell in a handbasket and that, you know, everything's messed up. And just watching that video for 30 seconds changed the way that I felt for the next 2 hours. 2 hours. Now you might sit there and go, oh, a 30 second video could not do that. There's no way. Well, it can. And because there's actually been a lot of studies on this. Yale did a study where they had, you know, they had these people come in and they said, hey, we're going to do a study on you. We're just going to have you read a piece of paper. And then what we're going to do is we're going to have you fill out a form and just a quick quiz about what you just read. And so it was the exact same story. It was the exact same quiz, but there was one difference that was made about the people walking in. What happened was the researcher would meet them at the lobby. And then they would go into an elevator and they would say, hey, I need to, you know, they're in the small elevator, say, hey, I need to tie my shoe. Can you hold on to my coffee for me? Half of the people in the research held a hot cup of coffee because that's what the researcher had. Half of the people in the research held a cold cup of coffee. They held the cup of coffee for about 10 to 15 seconds. The people who held a hot cup of coffee went and read a short story about somebody and then took a quiz. In the quiz, they said that they would trust that person. They seemed trustworthy, someone that was warm, someone that was kind. On the other side, the people who had a cold cup of coffee rated the exact same story, the exact same person with the exact same quiz as someone that is not trustworthy, someone that seems cold and cannot be trusted. So you've got to ask yourself, if holding on it's either a hot cup of coffee and a cold cup of coffee can change the way that somebody feels about somebody else in a story, is it possible that getting onto social media or getting a glimpse of a news station that happens to be playing as you're walking by it can influence the way that you feel in an hour, in 2 hours, in 3 hours. The answer to that is absolutely. So that's when you start to go, oh man, I really need to pay attention to what I'm packing in my box. I need to look at that box and pay attention to everything. If you put acid in that box, what's it gonna do? It's going to eat right through it. It's gonna destroy that box. So many people don't realize that they're unintentionally allowing acid to be poured into their brain every single day, and it's ruining the way that they feel throughout the entire day. That's what I mean by we're being brainwashed. So you can either be brainwashed with everything, good or negative. We're all being brainwashed every single moment, but you could also be in charge of your own brainwashing as well. And this is the one thing that I might protect more than anything else, is what comes into my brain. I'm so ridiculously anal about everything that comes into my brain. The books that I read, the people that I listen to, the social media accounts that I follow. I'm gonna tell you a true freaking story. You wanna hear a true story? Today, I saw somebody that I am very, very close with. And I mean like extremely close. I'm not gonna say anything else besides that because then it would be very obvious who this person is. I'm very close to this person. And I was like, I can't do it anymore. I just cannot follow this person on social media. Don't want to see the stuff that they post. Not helping me. I've never looked at their stories and been like, I feel really good about myself now. I was like, you know what? They got to go. There's a pretty good chance that they're going to notice because they don't have a whole lot of followers or anything. It's not like they have 10,000 followers or something. They're probably going to notice. Guess what? I don't feel bad about it. I don't. Not at all. And then I went, you know what? I already feel lighter by knowing that I'm never going to see this person post again. I feel good. I want to do this again. And so I literally went through and scrolled through, and I did this a few weeks ago, but I started deleting people who I am close with or know pretty well, but I just don't like the stuff that they post. I don't like the way that I feel after I see their stories or I see their posts, or doom and gloom, or this side is battling this side and my side's right and that side's wrong and all this stuff. And so I deleted like 7 people today from Instagram. I felt amazing. It was great. I think I'm going to delete 7 people every single day until I have like 4 left that I'm following. And so, you know, if you want to Google it and actually start to look into it, it's called unconscious priming. The study that was done in Yale is actually called unconscious priming. If you've ever gone to a Vegas show and there's a magician that's like a mind reader and stuff, they're unconsciously priming that person on stage the whole time to eventually get the answer that they want to out of them. People send me emails sometimes when I talk about brainwashing, or when they see me make a video about brainwashing, they're like, yeah, well, you're brainwashing me by me watching it. I'm like, yeah, no shit I am. But if I ever get to the point, or you ever get to the point where you look at the stuff that I'm creating and it's not serving you for the future that you're trying to create, please unfollow me. Stop listening to it. That's fine. I don't take any, I'm not hurt in any sort of way if someone were to look at the stuff that I'm doing and say, it doesn't serve me anymore. I'm okay with that because I'm not trying to brainwash people to make them do or say what I want them to do. I'm just putting out content that's helped me along the way. If it helps you, great. If it doesn't help you at a certain point, great as well. I'm not trying to, I have no agenda behind trying to manipulate people or any of that type of stuff. So it's not just me that's brainwashing you though. It's everybody. It's everything. It's all around you. It's the billboards that you go by. It's the news that you happen to hear. It's the commercials that are on the radio. Every single thing that you have is brainwashing. The people that you surround yourself with, the environment that you have in your house, in your car, in your office, all of those things are brainwashing in any sort of way. The question is it brainwashing you to the way that you want to be brainwashed? Or can you take control of the people that you surround yourself with, the people that you follow on social media, your environment, the stuff that you listen to, the books that you read, every single aspect, and go, you know what? I'm packing a box every single day. At the end of the day, if you look back into that box and you're like, I would give half of this to Goodwill, then stop allowing those things to get into the box. Stop allowing it to get into the brain and start taking control of what it is that you're doing and only meticulously place the things into your brain that you want to go into your brain that serve a purpose for your greater good to become the person that you want to be. Distance yourself as far away from everything that you can that's not serving your highest purpose, because either you brainwash yourself or you're going to be brainwashed. Hey, thanks so much for watching this video. If you want to learn even more about mastering your mind, click right here and watch this video as well. Can you be fulfilled where you are at this current moment with what you have and still want more? The answer is yes.